Howdy, folks. Today is 2 months since my amputation, and I'll give you another update. I'm still in my test socket. The process of getting into a permanent prosthesis has been delayed a little bit because of the COVID-19 business. I have decided on a foot. I have decided on the Freedom Innovations Maverick Extreme AT, which is a fiberglass foot. I think it rates as a K3 to K4 type activity foot. Now, how is my leg doing? Well, let's have a look. So, as far as day-to-day issues with wearing my prosthesis, there is very little fluctuation in swelling, which I hear is quite a big problem with a lot of amputees. I'm not sure if that's because I had the Ertl procedure. My limb feels quite muscular, but basically right now, all I'm wearing is this thin liner over top my limb liner. Sometimes I will go as much as a 5-ply sock, which also goes over top. But usually this little guy is enough. So that's the pin lock liner. And I will show you what my leg looks like. So this is my limb at 2 months. Get a little bit of redness after walking, but it's just like a superficial redness. The main incision is along the bottom here. Those were done with both dissolvable and regular stitches, which I had out on February 11th. My surgery was January 23rd. On the side, you'll see a scar where they relocated my peroneal nerve to get it away from my fibular head. That is supposedly a big source of aggravation for a lot of amputees, where the outside of their socket starts to push on this nerve. What does it feel like? Well, as you can see, it's not really flabby at all. It's quite firm. I had foot drop in this leg before my amputation, so I'm limited as to what I can move for muscles. I don't have any ability to flex this muscle. I have very little ability to flex my calf muscle. I don't know if you can see that or not. So, at the end of the day, what do when this guy comes off? I put on a shrinker. So, usually after washing up my limb, I'll put a little bit of moisturizer, sometimes some vitamin E, along the incision and on the side incision. After that gets all dried off, I'll put on a bit of a protective sheath on top of it, and then a shrinker sock. I have a couple different shrinker socks. This one is actually, right after I got my stitches on, it was so tight I could not get it onto my limb. Now I'm almost at the point of needing to get something with a little bit more compression. So I like to put it on so that the seam for the shrinker sock doesn't line up with the incision line. And then what I do is every night I'll rotate it, sometimes straight up and down, sometimes at an angle. But I try to keep that in a different alignment than the incision on my limb. So at night, that guy comes on and keeps everything kind of in check. Then for sleeping, I also wear this. This is a Fairblock limb cover. These have been around for a while. It is a way of shielding, I guess, external radiation and electromagnetic waves to your body. It's almost like a linen type texture, and it has steel fabric woven inside of it. So I slip that on at night, Some people use these for phantom pain. Lucky enough, I don't get phantom pain, so I wear that just for healing purposes. So that stays with me all night. In the morning, all that comes off. Shrinker comes off. I'll take a look, make sure everything's looking pretty good. There is some special creams you can put on your limb to protect it throughout the course of the day. Then after those are massaged in and they dry up, you roll on your liner and depending on how swollen it is, you put on a bit of a ply liner. This is probably maybe equivalent to like a 2-ply. And like I said, this is a 5-ply. I don't really ever use this and this together. It's like, this is enough, or if that's not quite enough, I'll take that off, I'll put this on. Then slide down into the pin lock socket. You'll see here some clicks. 1, 2, 3. The pin at the bottom of this, I think, has space for 8 clicks. So I try to get between 3 and 5. And throughout the course of the day, as everything starts to loosen up, I'll slide down. You'll hear once in a while a little click. So anyways, there we go. Am I happy with my decision to amputate? Absolutely. The really weird thing is I actually have better proprioception in this prosthetic foot than I did when I had to wear my big weight-bearing brace. That brace basically tried to shield my foot from any external input, but I couldn't really judge where my foot was because it was this huge cumbersome mess. This feels a lot more agile, and there you go. 2-month update.